In the Idol studios, we have an audience waiting in anticipation. Here at the Kodak, we have 3,000 people. 30 million viewers watching at home, and countless A-list stars waiting in the wings. All of them with one very special goal: to raise money for disadvantaged children around the world and right here in America. Together, we're gonna save some lives. This is Idol Gives Back. I used to be able to do that. Okay, guys, let's head off to the studios. Cue the music one more time. Please don't stop. All right.
This is NASCAR champion Jimmy Johnson for Idol Gives Back. You've heard about the great organizations that are going to benefit from tonight's show. So please give back. Every single dollar counts and will make a difference. Call in at 1-877-IDOL-AID. That's 1-877-436-5243. Thank you.
Soy George Lopez para Idol Gives Back. Llámanos esta noche, por favor. Cada dólar que das hace una gran diferencia en las vidas de muchas personas. So, levanta el teléfono y danos lo que sea. El número es 1-877-IDOL-AID. Es 1-877-436-5243. Gracias.
Kylie Minogue here for Idol Gives Back. Please give us a call tonight. Every dollar you give makes a real difference. So pick up the phone and give what you can. Save a life tonight, save the world tomorrow. To find out how to donate, go to AmericanIdol.com. And a very big thank you.
You at home have made American Idol a huge success. Tonight is our way of saying thanks and your way of helping others by calling the show. Now, when it comes to giving back, this woman is in a league of her own. I'm out of breath from that dancing. I've got to go to the treadmill. As the First Lady of California, she's called on people of all ages to come together and serve their communities. She's made service fun, cool, and rewarding. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Maria Shriver.
Thank you, Ryan. Tonight, American Idol will once again introduce us to some remarkable organizations that are changing the lives of people here at home and around the world. All of these groups need your financial support to continue their life-changing work. But they and so many others also need your time, your creativity, and your passion. In other words, they need you. You know, Gandhi once said that you can be the change you want to see in this world. And the truth is, you can be that change by serving others. Here in California, we seek to fuel people's souls with meaningful service opportunities through CaliforniaVolunteers.org. In fact, all of the people you see on this stage here with me tonight, and there are over 100 of them, are volunteers. Let's give them a round of applause. I'm incredibly proud to stand with all of them. And you at home can find out more information on how you can be of service to your community by logging on to AmericanIdol.com. Let's set a record tonight, not just with the amount of money we raise, but also with the number of people we enlist to volunteer. In the ancient Hopi prayer, it says, "Don't look outside yourself for the leader." It tells us we are the ones we've been waiting for. Ladies and gentlemen, when we come together with our generosity, our passion, and our compassion, we truly can change the world. We can all be American idols in someone's life. It doesn't matter if you can't sing, because you can serve, and acts of service are the stuff that real idols are made of. So. Begin this evening with someone who gives time to volunteer.
Hi. I'm proud to say that this past year I recorded a cover album of Whitney Houston songs with the intention of donating the proceeds to Idol Gives Back. The album, entitled Stiller Whips Whitney's Ass for Charity, went on sale 3 months ago. Unfortunately, due to high overhead costs, I'm sorry to say I've lost Idol Gives Back approximately $3.2 million. However, to make up for that, tonight I believe that we can raise a googillion dollars. That's right. Now, some of you may be saying, how much is a googillion? Well, a googillion is a one followed by a googillion zeros. Some of you may be saying, hey, I'm crazy. Well, isn't that what American Idol is all about? Convincing crazy people that they belong on television? So please, do it for charity. Do it for me. Do it for the crazy people we love to watch. If a googillion of you just give $1, that's all it takes. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you to Jennifer Connelly for that. Tonight, you're going to see stars from every avenue of entertainment giving their time, like our next guest. You can download this exclusively on iTunes, and the net proceeds go to charity. Propped by the Snoop Youth Football League from L.A. and singing with Charlie Wilson, ladies and gentlemen, Snoop Dogg.
I'm a man, a guy,
I want you to wait in here
for my family, fighting these pressures in my life.
Everybody, come on.
I know my mind should be on shining and getting Grammys, but these streets won't say goodbye. Can't say goodbye, goodbye
to the blocks,
goodbye
to the hood.
I can't say goodbye
to the streets,
goodbye
to the hood,
goodbye
to the blocks.
I can't say goodbye
to the blocks that raised me, the enemies and the homies that made me tough enough to hang on the corners that would mold me. Critics wonder if I'm trying to be the old me, but if they think the old me ever left, then they don't really know me. And don't know we don't change, we just become OGs. You always addicted to the light, you just don't OT. Hey look, I own the streets before they owed me. It took me in what my mama didn't want me. Too wild to be a child, and pop's not around now. All I got now is the homies to teach me how to be a man or whatnot, how to break ounces into grams or whatnot. The reason I'm so nice with my hands or whatnot. You think I forgot? Oh no, yeah. Put your hands together like this, y'all. Come on.
I'm a man, I gotta take that. Yeah.
Just clap your hands like this, y'all.
I know where my mind should be.
It's so hard to say goodbye.
But you can't take the streets of the man.
Hi, I'm Kobe Bryant from the Los Angeles Lakers, here for Idol Gives Back. Please give us a call tonight. Every dollar you give makes a real difference. Pick up the phone and please give whatever you can. The number to call is 1-877-IDLE-AID. That's 1-877-436-5243. On behalf of the entire NBA family, thank you.
This is the game, Triple H with the WWE. Tonight, you're watching Idol Gives Back. So please, donate all that you can. Every little bit helps. Please call 1-877-IDLE-AID. That's 1-877-436-5243. And if you're not down with that, we've got two words for you. Please give.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Paula Abdul and Randy Jackson.
In this country is in crisis. It's staggering to think that nearly a third of the kids in America are overweight or obese.
Things are even worse in poorer areas, and our thanks to Allstate Insurance and their 14,900 agents who sponsored our trip for Save the Children. Check this out.
Paul and I travel to Goshen Elementary School. It's only about 180 miles from our American Idol studios in L.A.
But as the principal explained...
Hi.
Welcome to Goshen School.
It was a world away from the glamour of Hollywood.
I would say poverty is the main challenge in this community. It is very difficult for our families. Many of our parents work very long hours.
One of the main jobs here is picking fruit and vegetables in the fields. The per capita income is less than $9,000 a year.
I give massive big hugs, really big.
We met with Christian, who showed us around.
Where are we going first?
To the messed up streets.
It may look like a peaceful town, but gang activity makes it a dangerous place for children.
What do the other kids do? Where do they play?
Most of them don't come out of their houses because they're scared that they might do a drive-by.
Oh, wow.
Wow.
Not only are the streets unsafe, but there's also a lack of resources here.
Our children don't have parks to play in. They don't have public swimming pools.
I wish there was more fields that could be safe for kids to play.
Many of our kids have forgotten how to be a kid because of all the struggles that they're faced with. And I see that a lot. I'm sorry.
Save the Children runs a program where the local kids can come and get help with their reading and have some healthy food.
What do I do? What do I do?
Above all, it's a place that they can play and be children again.
Oh. We've seen a bunch of amazing, brave kids that are really good-natured and smart and got their heads on right, and they're dealing with a lot of adversity in their lives outside of school.
Please call 1-877-IDLE-AID and help support programs like this all over the country.
It's been blocked up since I got in here this morning.
All it was some stuff caught up in here. So if it ever happens again, you just take this off and you can put it right back on. It's no big deal.
What's going on?
Nothing.
Nothing. Well, it doesn't look like nothing is going on. If you are going to steal my man, then I am going to steal your song. That's what I'm doing. I'm going to go steal your song.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Terry Hatcher and Band from TV.
Right now, he's probably slow dancing with a bleach blonde tramp, and she's probably getting frisky. Right now, he's probably buying her some fruity little drink, cause she can't shoot whiskey. Right now, he's probably up behind her with a pool stick showing her how to shoot a combo. We don't know that I dug my key into the side of his pretty little souped up four-wheel drive, got my name into his leather seat. I took a Louisville slug and a gold-plated light, slashed my hole in all four tires. Maybe next time he'll think.
Nice job, Terry.
That was a lot of fun, but of course we are here for much more than fun tonight.
Yeah, the money that you're donating tonight will change lives forever. So please, please keep giving.
Backstage and still to come, Billy Crystal, Miley Cyrus, and Carrie Underwood.
Hi, I'm Mary Murphy for Idol Gives Back. Woo-hoo! I'm going to do this all night long until you pick up the phone and give something back. The number is 1-877-IDOL-AID. That's 1-877-436-5243. Or go to the website, AmericanIdol.com. And thank you. Woo-hoo!
Please call very quickly. We can't take this much longer.
Oh, goodness, would somebody please pick up the phone out there and make me stop?
Do call tonight and give whatever you can.
With your cash, we can save lives here in the U.S. and in Africa.
The number is 1-877-IDOL-AID.
That's 1-877-436-5243. Thank you so much.
Recently retired from the New York Yankees, please welcome Billy Crystal.
Thank you so much. That's very nice. Thank you. I appreciate it a lot, because since I retired from baseball, I just don't know what to do with myself. It's great to be here. I love American Idol. I watch Idol all the time because it helps me keep my finger on the pulse of American pop culture and music. Without Idol, I wouldn't know how to use the words yo dog in a sentence. And it's not even about dogs, but this stage is where dreams come true. And I met a very talented young girl this week in rehearsal, and she had a dream about singing on American Idol. And they've asked me to present it to you so this dream can come true. That's pretty exciting, isn't it? I hope I get her name right. Please welcome a talented newcomer, Miss Miley Cyrus.
Hello, how are you?
Hi, how are you? Good to see you.
Good to see you.
Wow. You must have a lot of family in the audience. That's exciting. So, you're an up-and-coming new singer, I believe.
Yeah, that's right.
Well, that's great. Well, listen, don't be nervous. You know, I know when I started out, I was nervous, too. You know what I used to do? I used to pretend the audience was naked. That used to relax me a lot, so...
Uh-huh.
Yeah, so... How old are you?
I'm 15.
Wow, 15. I have projects in development longer than that, so... I heard you warming up backstage, and you're sensational, and have you thought about putting out any records?
Ooh, I've actually had two, and they... I was so excited. They both made it to number one, which was so cool.
That's a good start.
Yeah.
Two number ones is a very good start.
Oh, thank you. And by the way, just to let you know, they're not called records anymore.
I knew that.
CDs, you know, email like MP3, you know.
Fine. Have you thought about acting at all? Because, listen, if you want to get into movies, that's a whole other thing, because once that camera comes in, acting is all with the eyes.
Oh, I just did a movie. Oh, my gosh, yeah, and it was number one at the box office.
Really? That's pretty great.
So, are you in show business?
Well, not now, apparently, but I've done a few things.
Anything I would know of?
When Harry Met Sally. City Slickers. Analyze This. I won a Tony on Broadway 2 years ago for my one-person show. I've hosted the Oscars 8 times.
I was just there!
Oh, you did?
I presented. I didn't see you there. Why weren't you invited?
Well, actually, I like to watch it at home.
Oh.
And I was the voice of Mike Wazowski in Monsters Incorporated. You know,
are you crazy?
Yeah.
No way! it. Oh my gosh, I've got to get an autograph. That is unbelievable. Put that thing back where it came from, or so help me.
That's right.
I love that song. Right. It was one of my favorites.
Right.
It inspired me for sure. I love it.
Yeah, I was a little green one-eyed guy.
Yeah. Mike, I know you.
I look like CBS on legs.
Yes.
That was me.
I cannot believe it. You're famous too. That is so cool.
So let me ask you this. How long have you had a dream to sing on American Idol?
Forever. I mean, this is the one thing that I haven't had the chance to do yet, so I'm so excited to be here.
All right, you know what? Your dream's about to come true. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome a talented newcomer, Miss Miley Cyrus.
It's Miley Cyrus. Miley Cyrus.
You're her. I thought when you came out with Liberace's jacket, you must be somebody special, and it's you. It's you. Ladies and gentlemen, my new best friend, Miss Miley Cyrus.
Are you overloaded, candy-coated, your license loading now? There's a risk worth taking, a pain worth aching on this hollow ground. We can't let go, don't hold on to all the life's hardest parts. And when we think of stopping, let's keep on rocking to the rhythm of our hearts. To our parents. You can help too. Please give whatever you can. Even $1 can save a life. Now let's see if Ryan has made it back to the Idol studio.
Yes, Miley, we are here. I'm on the stage with your top 12 Chakizzi bag with us. What's up, man? If you donate tonight, you may get to talk to Saisha on the phone. So call now.
Ryan, we got Marty here from Houston, Texas.
Marty?
She donated $250, but she said if you'd come over and maybe sing at her birthday party, that she'd bump it up to five.
Marty Seacrest, I'm on the air, but I'm on my way after this direct, okay? Okay, we'll pin the tail on the donkey. Okay, she's really there. I love that. Thanks, Marty. Appreciate it. The numbers, 1-877-IDOL-AID. It's 1-877-436-5243. Or you can donate at AmericanIdol.com. And a big shout-out to our sponsors for the night. Our thanks to News Corporation, ExxonMobil, Ford, Coca-Cola, AT&T, iTunes, 19, Fremantle Media, Allstate Insurance Company, and the Mac AIDS Fund, whose donation was made possible by the sale of Mac's Viva Glam lipstick. Who you got, Cook?
I got Amy from Massachusetts and with her two kids.
Amy, hey, it's Ryan. You're on the air with us right now. We can't hear you, but we can wave to you. Thanks for watching. Thanks for your donation. Okay. Yes, that's really him. No, Ryan Seacrest. Ryan's, never mind. The sponsors have already pushed us to over $15 million. That's incredible. Already. And you can add to it as we speak. Now, here's a report from Bono in Africa for Idol and the Global Fund.
Meet Usabia. I think she might be an actual angel. A volunteer, her whole life is spent caring for those affected by AIDS.
There are so many patients and so many orphans.
So would you try to drop in on her, what, once a week?
This community is one of many decimated by AIDS. We're off to see Sophia, a 14-year-old orphan who was born HIV positive. After getting a checkup from the local nurse, I wanted to know if Sophia had anything special to say to America.
Napenda tu kuambia waendelee kuangalia hivyo hivyo ile wajue afya yangu ilivyo na kunisaidia pia.
Well, we're going to help you. You see in the camera? That's America over there. And let me tell you this, Sophia. Every single person who's watching American Idol now, they want to see you get better. And they're going to do the right thing by you and make sure that other girls like you get these two pills that it'll take to keep you alive. You are a hero to us, Sophia. 14-year-old girl fighting back against something that you'd know part of.
Helping Sophia through her pain is Usabia, who really is a remarkable woman. Sophia is just one of 60 patients she supports as a volunteer. And Sophia is suffering from AIDS. She has no parents, no electricity. Yet during our visit, she never stopped doing her schoolwork.
We are pleading that you can help us. We have thousands and thousands of patients who are really in need. And we need your help.
And then I found out why Usabia's heart was so on fire.
Have you had direct experience of HIV yourself in your family?
Of course. I have three kids who died of HIV.
Three children.
One child than any mother can bear. Two? Three?
Three is an agony. I can't describe what type of pain for a mother to lose a child. You can't say how you feel it, but there's pain.
Just to everybody at home, you know, just this is your chance to be part of this incredible lady's story. This is serious. This woman is fighting for the life of her community. So please call 1-877-IDLE-AID. Thank you, American Idol. And thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
You've seen how much good your money can do. Please dial 1-877-IDLE-AID. That's 1-877-436-5243. Or go to the website, AmericanIdol.com, and give whatever you can. Kids all over the world are desperately in need, and tonight you can help. And thank you to American Idol for including Save the Children, and good luck to everybody.
Please welcome Fergie with John Legend.
Since I was a baby girl, I had a dream, Cinderella theme, crazy as it seems. Always knew that deep inside that there would come that day, but I would have to wait, make so many mistakes. I couldn't comprehend as I watched it unfold, this classic story told. I left it in the cold, walking through an open door that led me back to you. One unlocking more of the truth. I finally stopped tripping on my youth. I finally got lost inside of you. I finally know I needed to grow. And finally my mate has met my soul. Finally, now my destiny can begin. Though we will have our differences, something beautiful is happening. It's happening. I finally. Now my life doesn't seem so bad. It's the best that I've ever had. Give my love to him, fire
Welcome to two of my idols, the phenomenal Heart.
Gentlemen, this is the WWE's John Cena coming to you on behalf of Idol Gives Back. It's a very important cause, and I want you to know that if you call now, any donation that you make will make a real difference. The number is very important. It's 1-877-IDOL-8.
Hey, everybody, Adam Sandler here. Please dial 1-877-IDOL-8. Give some money. Help people out, it'll feel good. I know someone who just did it, and they're feeling great right now, right?
I know, how cute. It's so cute. I love that guy.
Okay, we are still here live at the Idol Studio.
Hang on for 1 second.
The Idol Studios, now these aren't the only people answering the phones. We have thousands of operators standing by, so call right now, all right? Pick up the phone. If you're lucky, they'll put you through to the idols, to our contestants here on the stage. Now, calling isn't... Hang on 1 second. I'm going to give you to Saisha. Yeah, Mercado. Saisha Mercado. Hang on 1 second. I just got to get... Yeah. Okay, so Now, calling isn't the only way you can donate. You can download tonight's music on iTunes. Also, each week from now until the finale, Stamps.com will offer commemorative stamps featuring each of the past six winners plus this year's winner. Yes.
Kelly wants you to blow her a kiss into the camera, and she said she'll double the money to 100.
Okay. Yes, yeah, absolutely. It's kind of all right. And by the way, all the net proceeds go to charity. Yeah. And it's not Kelly. Thanks, Mike. Okay, bye-bye. Head over to AmericanIdol.com for more details. Right now, back to the Kodak for back-to-back Super Bowl heroes, Eli and Peyton Manning.
Unlike all the other stars here tonight, we're more at home on a football field rather than up here on stage.
This event is so important to both of us that we wanted to take part. It's been nearly 3 years since Hurricane Katrina hit our hometown of New Orleans, and its effects are still being felt by a generation of children.
As Peyton and I know, a quarterback is nothing without the rest of the team. So we went back home to see how some of Katrina's youngest victims are learning to deal with the trauma through teamwork.
Take a look at this.
When Katrina struck New Orleans, thousands of kids saw images they shouldn't.
During Katrina, I saw dead bodies, people killing themselves. I even saw children crying on their knees, hoping that they won't die.
I saw people screaming, helicopters coming down from the sky.
There was a lot of chaos going. Everybody was scared.
It was a lot of people of all races and no food.
How you doing?
What's happening, guys?
What's happening?
What y'all doing?
Through organized games and activities, teamwork, and just talking, these kids are making a fresh start away from Katrina's shadow.
Yeah, a little teamwork there, man. I don't think anybody can relate to what these kids dealt with, except for the ones that were here.
It's good to hear everybody's stories and let them know they're not alone in this. There's other people there who are fighting through some of the same things.
Where does that come to your mind when you think of the storm?
It made me feel bad because that could have been me or my family members.
It took, like, friends. It took, like, five of my friends.
When you lose something you can't replace.
I feel alone.
I think Katrina made me feel better because I think I got strong being a better man, a better boy.
Great being here with all of you and hearing all your stories and just what all y'all been through and how y'all have kept the spirit.
If they did not have this opportunity, they would not be able to focus on their schoolwork the way they can focus because they now have the opportunity to address some of the issues that they're thinking about.
One, two, three.
Teamwork!
With your help, more kids can begin to rebuild a future.
A term we use in football is, hey, I got your back. And that's kind of what I think this program's about. These kids kind of have each other's back. Their message is very clear, what they saw and what they've been dealing with since. They need to have the support of the people. You can help make a difference to kids who have experienced severe trauma by making that call.
And giving what you can. The number is 1-877-IDOL-AID.
That's 1-877-436-5243.
Both David and myself have been extremely lucky. We've travelled the world and enjoyed success in many countries.
But there are people far less fortunate than ourselves who are forced to remain in poverty, hunger, and even fear of their lives. War, famine, and disease are a daily threat.
So tonight we're asking you to contribute to IDOL Gives Back in order to help these people make a better life for themselves. Just $1 can make the world of difference when you have no world.
Please head to AmericanIdol.com to find out how you can join Victoria and myself in donating. Thank you.
Welcome back to IDOL Gives Back. We are live in Hollywood here. David's been on one call all night. Get through him, baby.
Brian,
anything you can give, we appreciate it. It makes a difference. Yes, Aisha.
Chris
from Mobile, Alabama, right?
He's a realtor. He says hi to everybody. So okay. Say hi to him, guys.
Okay. Hi, Chris. Thank you. Remember, there's a chance you can get through right now and talk to the idols on television. Thanks again to ExxonMobil and News Corporation for their donations. Seacrest here. Hang on one second. I'm going to go over here to Christy Lee Cook. All right, what do we got? Who do you got? Who do you got?
Debbie.
Okay, Debbie. Debbie's on the air. And Michael, who do you got? Who do we got?
I go Beth from Cleveland. Beth,
okay, we know Chris. All right, good. Now, I just jotted down my notes here on the napkin. Close to $18 million, people. Close to $18 million. Okay. Hey, how are you? Hang on one sec. Let's go back to Bono in Africa with a report on how orphan children are keeping their parents' memories alive.
This is a memory box. You lost your mom and your dad.
Yeah.
Both to HIV/AIDS.
Yes.
When people lose their families, in the case of Jaloy here, he's lost his mother and his father. They try to keep the memories of the people they've lost alive. Can I have a look in here?
The things, when I looked at them, I remember my parents, and I feel like they're there. Always makes me happy.
That is beautiful. Are you a good student?
Yeah.
You smart?
Yes.
And what is your dream to be?
I want to be a judge.
A judge. So you have a strong sense of right and wrong.
Yes.
And it's not right what happened to you. We're going to go to South Africa, from Dar es Salaam in Tanzania, to a woman, a girl, with the voice of an angel. And she's going to tell you about what she's been doing, Annie Lennox. She is a precious gem.
Do you have a father?
I do.
Where's your mother? Do you have any grandparents? Do you have an auntie?
This little family of brothers have lost everyone they loved to AIDS. Everyone who cared for them. Sibo is the eldest, and he's just 15. He's all they've got.
We sometimes don't have the means to survive. When one of the little ones gets sick and needs medical care, I can't get them to hospital.
Today, we're taking the boys in our vehicle to get them tested for HIV.
This is quite a long journey. We're doing it in a van. But if the boys had to walk to the clinic, it would take them hours, and this little one's only three.
If Sibo is positive, access to treatment is going to be vital because the little ones depend on him. After all they've been through, these children could face losing each other because any one of them could be infected with the AIDS virus.
That your results are HIV negative. Good news for you.
All of the boys are negative. It's fantastic news. But it's almost impossible to take in. They're just children. They should be carefree. For a while, today, they were.
Three, four, and nine.
Ready for nine. Here we go. Woo!
The thought that haunts me as a mother is what it must have been like for their mum. Knowing she was dying and leaving her four children to fend for themselves. Across Africa, children are living like this. The parents could still be with them if only they'd been diagnosed and given the treatment they needed.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Thanks very much.
You're welcome.
You're welcome.
Talk to me.
the oldest boy is so dignified. He has to hold his feelings in so much because it's such a impossible situation. And then we gave each other a hug in the end. It's just so sweet. And yeah. Okay, let's go. It's really hard.
People do not have to die from AIDS. So, if you feel like I do, that this is all wrong, then you must get on board.
By changing lives tonight, in 24 hours, you can change the world. So please, give whatever you can, and thank you.
Hello, Celine Dion here in South Africa for Idol Gives Back. I've been seeing the great work paid for with last year's funds. All of these kids are orphans whose lives have been affected by AIDS. Your money has helped provide crucial support and also to fund the adults who look after them. The most heartbreaking statistic is that there are over 2 million children like these
who are affected. The people of Africa desperately need our support. Please call 1-877-IDLE-AID. That's 1-877-436-5243. Thank you for caring.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Jimmy Kimmel.
Well, thank you. I've been asked tonight to introduce Simon Cowell. Actually, a lot of people were asked to introduce him, but no one else would do it. Hi, Simon. Simon Cowell is the reason Governor Schwarzenegger must work to secure the borders of this country. All the good feelings about the British Mary Poppins brought here, he has undone. This event tonight is for a wonderful cause, but I think we should set just a little bit of the money that we raised tonight aside to buy Simon a shirt that fits him. Simon, I know you've had that black V-neck since the fourth grade, but... And I'm sure there's an emotional attachment, but it's time to let it go. It really is.
Okay.
You know, they say people like and relate to Simon because he says what the rest of us are thinking. But if that's the case, why hasn't he said anything about the fact that his nipples are the size of pepper mills? On many nights, it looks like you are smuggling the Olsen twins in under your shirt. Fortunately for Simon, they do draw attention away from that ridiculous haircut, honestly. Who parts that for you, Moses? Is that a hairstyle in England? Because I've never seen it here before. Simon, you make $40 million a year. It's time to step up from supercuts. It really is. But back to Simon's nipples, if I may. You know, people sometimes think Paula is crying on the show. No, it's his nipples keep poking her in the eyes. Truth be told, Simon, I know Simon, he's a good man. He supports a number of charities, not just this one and these. He supports PETA in their work against cruelty to animals. Simon feels strongly that cruelty should be reserved exclusively for the contestants on this show. But the fact is, American Idol without Simon Cowell would be like Christmas without the Grinch. It would be like a picnic without ants. It would be like Ryan Seacrest without the faux hawk. And I think I speak for all of America when I say, let's see you sing something, Simon. And button your shirt. Ladies and gentlemen, Simon Cowell.
In America, there are over 50 million people without the necessary health care and insurance. 15 million of those are children. Children just like yours. I travelled to New York to visit a group of doctors and nurses who are providing desperately needed health care to homeless and low-income families from a fleet of mobile medical units, paid for with your donations.
We thought that it would be best to bring the care to the population and to make sure that these people weren't falling through the cracks and that they were getting comprehensive care.
One family who rely on the work of the Children's Health Fund is Irene and her two children, Vanessa and Macha.
Thank you for allowing me in.
No problem. Thank you for coming to my home.
After being evicted from their apartment, the family is crammed into two rooms at Irene's mum's. Macho spent 2 years in a wheelchair. He's just got out of the hospital where he had four pins inserted into his knee. And despite having rheumatoid arthritis, Vanessa has to sleep on the sofa.
You know, it's hard for me because of the fact that young people should be able to run, they should be able to play, you know. We're supposed to be active and, you know, that's not the case for me anymore.
And Irene, you haven't been well yourself, have you?
No, I have lupus.
Which is?
It's an autoimmune body disease.
Yeah.
In the beginning, I didn't want my kids to know that mommy's sick, you know. That's not something you go and tell them.
And what would have happened without the clinic?
Who knows? She'd probably be... Excuse me. She'd probably be deformed.
Hey.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. I just think that if I had to do it by myself,
It would have been worse. It would have been worse.
Deep breath. Deep breath. Sorry, my hands might be cold.
Tell America what you'd like them to do.
Oh, I would like for them to just donate, 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 and just keep giving, give from the heart, because you're giving to the children and those families that are being helped like mine. I'm sorry.
You can help us to help families like Irene's by simply picking up the phone and donating as much as you can. Call 1-800-IDOL-AID or go online to AmericanIdol.com.
What I witnessed in New York was incredible. What this charity does, very simply, is save lives. I met some of the nicest people I've ever met, the doctors, the families. Apart from the job they do, they treat everyone with total respect. And to the family who you just saw, I hope you're enjoying watching the show. And for everyone who's donated, if you can afford it, thank you very much indeed. Jimmy Kimmel, I'd just like to say how much I love the Jay Leno show. I remember a few years ago saying on American Idol, a certain contestant will sell more records than any other contestant. And as usual, I got it right. Last year, she was in Africa. I am delighted to say that she's here. Ladies and gentlemen, the incredible Carrie Underwood.
They will not be the last. Look around now. These are the days of the beggars and the choosers. This is the year of the hungry man, whose place is in the past. Hand in hand with ignorance and legitimate excuses. No hope to speak of, and the wound.
I hope you go into the phone, because I do want you to call tonight and give whatever you can. Give your cash. Go in your pocket. You know you ain't used all of it. We can save lives here and in the U.S. and in Africa. I mean, we can do a lot. The number is 1-877-IDLE-A.
Hi, it's me, Oprah. And if you're like me and you like to help people, here is your chance. You're watching Idle Gives Back. So jump in on the action, won't you? Just grab your phone. You probably don't even have to grab it. It's probably in your pocket or your backpack or right here on your belt if you're a contractor. Anyway, you grab your phone and you dial these numbers. You don't dial. Nobody dials anymore. Who dials? It's just pushing. But that's what you do is push. That's not even strenuous. You have no excuse. Here's what you do. You dial this number. Push this number. 1-877-436-5243. And you know what I did? I had some spare time. And so I looked up what those numbers could possibly say. And they say 1-877-IDLE-AID. Isn't that a coincidence? What's that, Stedman?
Ladies and gentlemen, Gloria Estefan.
In places, but she pulled it out in the end, right? That song is so inspiring. I almost got up and made it happen. Then I was just like, I'll do it tomorrow. I'll get up and make it happen tomorrow. Wow. Idle Gives Back. I watched it last year and now I'm here and it's amazing. There's so much amazing talent on stage right now. Thank you. All right. Now for the reason we're here, the serious part. Malaria kills between 1 and 3 million people every year, most of whom are children. ExxonMobil helped us with the next film. Their executives, Dr. Stephen Phillips and Fernando Pegado, are here with us tonight, so thank you guys. A along with the dedicated organization of Malaria No More, the amazing Forrest Whitaker, and his wife, Keisha. She's probably amazing, too. I don't know her. She could be a nightmare. They went to Angola and sent back this report.
One of the world's biggest killers isn't war or starvation, but a wholly preventable disease, malaria.
One million people die every year. Every 30 seconds, a child dies. We're in Angola, in Luanda, and we're gonna see how this crisis is affecting so many people.
Help, I have done it
all. 8-month-old Maria has been admitted to the hospital, suffering from severe malaria. The disease has reached Maria's brain, causing massive swelling and seizures. This could result in brain damage, or even death. Maria's mom, Amelia, is understandably concerned.
She's worried about the fact that the baby can become disabled.
It's an anxious wait. Was Africa's biggest killer about to take another life? Be my friend. By the time we met up with Maria, her condition had improved.
Buen dia.
She lost a bit of the awareness, and she can become comatose.
Will she recover from this?
Yes. And even the ones who recover can have neurological problems
side
afterwards.
Effects.
Exactly.
A simple $10 net could have prevented all of this.
At home, will they have any way to help prevent it, like some mosquito nets or anything? Yeah. Or?
Lá na sua casa, tem alguma coisa para evitar a malária? No, she doesn't have a mosquito net.
It's amazing that, like, a net can stop these kind of things from happening.
But Amelia, supporting a family of nine, $10 is an impossible sum to save.
These kids are dying and they're sick for really no reason.
Every 30 seconds, we've been talking here for like a minute, two children have died. It's incomprehensible.
Thousands of families across Africa don't have access to the emergency medical treatment that saved Maria.
One net, one pill, one life. Let's save 1 million lives together. $10 per net, that's all it costs. $2 to buy the medication to save lives. One net, one pill, one life. Let's do it together. Let's do it together.
Let's make tonight historic.
Now, just because you don't see us up here on this stage doesn't mean you shouldn't call in. We are here, live. The Idol's answering these calls. Now, if the lines are busy...
Yes, we got a call.
All right, hang on. All right, 2 seconds. If the lines are busy, you can go to the website, AmericanIdol.com. Donate there. A child dies every 30 seconds, and your donations will help end these tragic deaths. Now, I'll take some calls. Watch this tape. Here is a remarkable announcement from Gordon Brown, the Prime Minister of Great Britain. Take a look at this.
Good evening from Downing Street in London. All year on Idol, it's the talent of the American people we admire. But tonight, it's your generosity. Every 30 seconds, an African child dies of malaria. But sometimes, big problems have small solutions. And we can help stop these deaths with a simple $10 mosquito net. With 120 million more nets, all families could sleep safe at night. So this evening, I'm promising that Britain will pay for 20 million more. And I'll be urging other world leaders to play their part. You can help, too, by donating tonight. There's nothing more amazing than saving a life. And your money will do just that. Thank you. And God bless you all.
So do you realize what he has just said? Great Britain is giving the equivalent of $200 million. That's 20 million nets at $10 each.
I have Lynn in Indiana.
Lynn. So, Lynn, why not donate $10 now and let your family save another life and another family? You did it? I love you.
Yes.
Thank you. All right, hang on. Here's Carly. Let's see. Yes. Okay, let me tell Brooke. Brooke, I have more notes on a napkin.
Okay.
We're up to almost $22 million.
Yay!
Brooke, when we come back, the top eight, they're going to take the stage, all right? You can download them on iTunes, Brooke. Proceeds go to charity. We'll be right back live Yes. No, this is navy blue. Yeah.
Remember, tonight you can change a life. Tomorrow you can change a world. Call 1-877-IDLE-AID.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Academy Award winner, Reese Witherspoon.
When Idol Gives Back asked me to take part tonight, I didn't hesitate for a moment. I knew exactly the charity that I wanted to spotlight. If we're going to eradicate poverty in this country, we need to start with children. And nothing is more important than education. That's where the Children's Defense Fund comes in. I traveled to New Orleans to visit one of their freedom schools. Take a look at this.
In America, every day, nearly 2,500 high school students drop out.
In America, every 3 hours, a child is killed by a firearm.
In America, every 4 minutes, a child is arrested for drug abuse.
When kids grow up in poverty, it's tough to keep them out of trouble. I traveled to New Orleans where I met Lillian, a single mom struggling to raise her 13-year-old daughter, Calvinica, in one of the city's most deprived neighborhoods.
I knew this lady that lives down the street, and her 4-year-old son shot himself in the head. 4 years old.
That is horrible.
I just pray every night to ask the Lord to give me the strength to get up every morning and go to work and take care of my kids.
You're doing an amazing job.
Lillian and Calvinica live with 7 other relatives, and everyone is reliant on Lillian's minimum wage.
It's hard on me because I have to work and try to, you know, maintain the house and make sure they have things that they need.
We can't do it alone. Nobody does it alone.
Right.
You know, we need communities. We need to get around each other as people and care about each other and put our arms around each other.
Living where they do, it would be easy for Calvinica to go off the rails.
Since Katrina passed, a lot of more students, a lot more fighting, police coming to school, drugs and everything. It's really bad. Right. Really, really bad.
But there is hope.
Higher feeling!
Calvinica attends a free after-school program called Freedom School, where the idea is to inspire a new generation of community leaders to break the cycle of poverty and violence.
It keeps me out of trouble. I go every day. It helps me.
The Freedom School did help her on her attitude a lot and told her she's a leader and not a follower.
I'm one of their number one students.
In America, every 35 seconds, a baby is born into poverty.
In America, every 6 hours, a child dies of abuse or neglect.
We can make a difference if we get more help. We don't want to lose a generation of young people.
This makes things a lot better for me as a single parent.
Yeah.
With 3 kids.
And if we just get people out there to give more money to these programs, it's going to help all these communities rebuild.
Well, I can guarantee you it will help because it helped me.
The work that's being done here is fantastic. It's helping so many children. There's over 124 Freedom Schools helping over 70,000 kids, but we want to double that, triple that.
Help us make that happen. Pick up the phone and call 1-877-IDLE-AID. That's 1-877-436-5243.
Everyone out there, it would mean so much to so many.
And welcome back to the Idol Studios Live. We're hearing some people can't get through, so if the lines are busy, please go to our website, AmericanIdol.com. Tomorrow night, Bono is going to talk about other ways you can get involved through One.org. Plus, we'll have your American Idol results. But for now, here are the American Idols singing Seasons of Love.
$525,600 $525,000 moments so dear. 525,600 minutes. How do you measure a year? In
daylights and sunsets and midnights and cups of coffee in inches and miles and laughter and strife in 525,600 minutes. How do you measure a year in the life? How about
iTunes. The net proceeds will go to charity. Now we're going to go back to the Kodak Theater. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Dane Cook.
Alicia Keys is a testament to young people standing up for what they believe in. She is the global ambassador for Keep a Child Alive, an organization that provides AIDS care and support to Africans who need it. Tonight, we have a real exclusive for you. If you go to AmericanIdol.com, while you're donating, you can download Alicia's complete journey across Africa for free. Or you can download my complete journey across Burbank for $6. And it's not as compelling. Here's a preview of what she experienced.
In April last year, we decided to go to 3 countries in Africa. If only everyone could come to Africa, I mean, I know it would change them all. Helping us all to realize our blessings and see such amazing beauty and realize how little it takes to do so much good for people in need. It's crazy when you think about it, how you can change the lives of people forever for the price of a pair of shoes.
Hi.
Because of the AIDS pandemic, there are 13 million African children orphaned. The burden has fallen to their grandmothers, who, in African custom, should be cared for by their children in their later years, but instead are now raising their grandchildren in the most difficult of circumstances. For example, this grandmother lost all 4 of her children and now has been left to support all 8 of her grandchildren.
So eventually she had to take over the full responsibility.
All of them died from AIDS?
Yeah.
How does she manage? How does she manage to care for all 8 of the children?
Normally she does small jobs, so she gets small money. If that does not come around, then she has to go borrow from any neighbor.
For many years, people used the excuse that there was no point in giving AIDS medicine to Africans because they would not take them efficiently or they wouldn't seek treatment. Even though these grandchildren had only the clothes they were wearing when we met them, and a grandmother often has to dig graves to survive, she keeps that box of ARVs for the children in her one-room house, and she makes sure that they take them. If AIDS got half of the attention the media gives to celebrity dramas, this issue would be well on its way to being solved. So I want to ask you, shall we be the generation that says no more injustice for the poor? Shall we commit to eradicating AIDS, extreme poverty, and war? Or shall we continue to allow ourselves no voice in the world our children will inherit? To see my whole journey to Africa, which is available free, and find out how to donate this evening, go to AmericanIdol.com. Spread love and give generously.
We're in Utah on the set of High School Musical 3, so we can't be there tonight, but we want to wish you all good luck.
Remember, there are people all over the world in need of food, shelter, and medicine. Tonight, we can all do something for them.
Kids, dig into your piggy banks. Parents, dig into your wallets.
We're all in this together, so pick up that phone and do whatever you can.
The number is 1-877-IDOL-AID.
That's 1-877-436-5243.
Good night,
and thank you.
Kentucky. It's where my parents grew up, and a few weeks ago, my dad and I traveled back there to make this film. Take a look at what we found.
This is Clay County, Kentucky.
I mean, this is where I'm from. This is Appalachia. Coal mines, steel mills, farms, and all of them are way down below the working level that they used to be when I was a kid.
There ain't no reason things are this way.
Sadly,
I know it's getting pretty serious up in here now.
I can't explain why we live this way. We do it every day.
Nearly 50% of the children here live below the poverty line, without the services and conveniences that we all take for granted. We're going to meet an extraordinary family, the Hensons and their three kids.
Hi, how are you?
Ronnie, Abigail, and Tiffany.
Hi.
They live in very difficult conditions.
Whole life working for something just to have it taken away.
I like for my kids to get out of here someday where they can further their education, you know, and make something of themselves.
But more than half of adults here never even finished high school. So it's not easy for them to help, especially if they can't afford books. Luckily, all three kids attended Save the Children's after-school program.
We're reading How Animals Move. We're reading a nonfiction book this week, and we've already started it.
They received help with their reading.
The cobra sways back and forth.
Their computer skills.
This is excellent.
And even their physical fitness. Do you have a favorite thing about your school?
Going to the computers.
Going to the computers.
Ooh. I love the computers, too.
The results have been dramatic. Last year in this program, the number of kids reading at grade level increased by 79%. And the program has expanded to help kids right from birth, delivering books to houses so the parents can start reading to them as babies.
Ooh, new books.
Some new books.
Wow, yay. Books are here.
Ooh.
Everybody around here, they don't have the money to go out and buy books. But if we can come into the home and show them, you can help your child develop and give it a love of reading, because they can go anywhere they want to go in a book.
What do you want to be?
I like to be a teacher.
You want to be a teacher? That'd be cool. You're learning to read, you're learning to be on the computer. You guys are definitely going to be teachers, good teachers too.
This may be one of the toughest living situations that I've ever witnessed. But in saying that, there's a lot of passion to learn.
Cock-a-doodle-doo, where are you going?
There's something very loving about the family that you see here. Set me free.
What we witnessed inside this home is hope.
There ain't no reason things are this way. It's how they always been and they intend to stay. I can't explain why we live this way. We do it every day.
Please call 1-877-IDLE-AID.
It's nice to see people of all ages getting involved, from as young as Miley to as old as Simon. Now, as I'm sure you're aware, the IDLE format airs all over the planet, including Russia, where they've just crowned their latest winner. Please welcome the Russian IDLE. Now, it's great to have you with us.
It's great to be here. You're a friend of Gary Busey. I love you.
Yes, he's been looking for me.
Gary Busey looked for you all the time.
He found me. Now, how do you say your name?
Ivan Yakinov. But for TV, Ivan Papinov. But you can call me Bob.
Okay, all right. Well, Bob, where are you from?
I'm a Bekov.
Okay, so...
Not the end of the world, but you can see it from there. Very beautiful place. Nice to be here in Hollywood at the Kodiak Theater. Great time. Yep. Beautiful.
And the fans all over now.
The fans everywhere.
Love the Russian Idol. What kind of television shows do they have back home?
In Russia, we have many shows like yours. We have the quiz show Meal or Not a Meal. We have Survivor Siberia. And my favorite show, So You Think You Can Drink. I love that show. Very beautiful.
What sort of music do you sing back then?
In Russia, we sing Russian covers of American songs like Babushka, You Is My Woman Now. Also, we have a great Midnight Train to Georgia means something totally different. Very beautiful.
We did a Beatles night here on our show.
Oh, that's
show.
A great thing.
You're a Lennon fan.
Lennon, yes. I also did this. I did a song by Lennon. Also, I did one by Stalin.
Ah.
Great song.
Yes.
His favorite song is Every Move You Make, I'll Be Watching You. Great one. This is a Stalin joke. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
I'll ask the questions.
Sorry.
Okay. Siebel, you say that.
Bob, what was your studio audience like?
A standard, well, the typical member of Russian studio audience is about this big, yeah. About 200 pounds, some facial hair, and the men are a little taller. They're all, you know, like that, you know. And it's a great show, though. It's
no, it sounds...
My father won Anti-American Idol in 1978. It was great.
I think it's time for him to audition. Are you ready? Because we'd love to have you.
That's why I can't hear.
Please, the judges.
The judges.
Randy.
The girls. I love it here. Hello. Oh, I got to Randy, talk to them. Nice.
Say hi to Bob, Randy.
What's up, baby? What's
Yo,
going
baby,
on?
Yo, baby, must go. Let's throw it down. Look at you dressed in Dracula's coat. Way to
go. Oh, yeah, yeah.
Way to go. Hello. You are so beautiful.
Thank you,
I would walk 50 miles in the snow to stand in your garbage. I would. And you, Simon, with your man breasts, what are you doing? Your man breasts and the hairy chest, you remind me of my sister. You look gorgeous. You are beautiful. You are a beautiful man. This is a song that won me, Russian Idol. It's Putin's favorite song. I would like to sing for you.
Good.
No, я только пьяный. Я люблю тебя, твои глаза. Камрад, это все на видео писать, но гаджи видазан. Вой гаджи, вана дарья с голован, я раваджо. My way. Thank you. God bless you. You are beautiful. Thank you. Don't you...
Okay.
Okay, do it, please.
Are you ready?
Okay. I'm ready.
Randy.
Go, puppy. Don't be afraid.
Let me just say it was forcibly pitchy.
Oh, pitchy.
Yeah, pitchy.
Not bitchy, but pitchy.
Pitchy, yes, pitchy. P.
Okay.
Yeah, P.
A little off.
Yes.
Okay, Paula, my beauty, my joy.
Nice shirt.
Nice shirt.
Yeah. Very
you know, I Elton colorful. John had a garage sale and I had to buy it.
I love it.
Diamond, what are you thinking?
I thought you were brilliant.
I love you right now in a Brokeback way. I love you.
Yes.
You know, can I touch you like a man to
come
man?
In.
Come
yes,
on,
please.
Please.
I need it.
I love you so much.
I love you too.
Ladies and gentlemen, I've been popping off.
It's Randy Millerwood. Thank you. This is great for
you. Congratulations.
Thank you. I only have one request. My dream. If I may say my dream, if they're out there watching, Brad and Angelina, I want you to adopt me.
We'll be right back. I'll get this back.
God bless you.
Thank you. Good to see you, Robert. Thank you.
Hi. My name's Rob Schneider. Now, you would think that Bono has enough money to fix whatever's going on in Africa. But apparently, he only has half. So that's why we need your help. So please call 1-877-436-5243. And also, feel free to send some money to me.
I'm Tyra Banks here for Idol Gives Back. Please give us a call tonight. Every dollar you give makes such a big difference. Pick up the phone and give what you can. It doesn't matter what, just what you can. The number is 1-877-IDOL-AID. That's 1-877-436-5243. And there is nothing more fierce than giving back. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome David Spade.
Hey, thank you. 3 years down the line and the process of rebuilding and repopulating New Orleans after Hurricane Katrina has been a slow and difficult one. Someone who has made it their mission to help get some of these displaced families back into homes is Brad Pitt.
This is like where everything started, everything was, everything should be.
It's not housing, it's homes. It's the family, where the memories were created, where they sent their kids to school, where they took their first steps, where they played with their friends.
You always know where home is, but for us from New Orleans, that sense of home has been totally taken away.
It's a gut-wrenching feeling when you have to throw away all your memories because they're either waterlogged or covered in mold.
Just living in a confined space, you know, it's kind of tough.
Like, everybody's scattered all over North Carolina, California. Some of them are out here.
I just want people to know that we are still struggling even 3 years later.
I do find this about America. When we understand the situation, we rally. What we've done is we've called on the good people of the old US of A to come in and lend a hand, and that's what's happened. That's why it's getting done. What you're going to see in a year from now is hopefully this filled with homes and a thriving community.
Think about it as a rebirth. You're making it happen. You're a part of the movement. It is a renaissance that's happening in New Orleans, and this being a part of that is significant. You know, we all could be a part of that.
What does it mean to you to come back?
This is where I was raised at. This is where I grew up. This is where everything started at, and I wanted to finish it.
I'm not the type of person to give up.
You have to fight for what you want, you know? This is the spirit of home.
This is my home.
They don't know they're not.
We're strong people.
Eventually, we'll get home. They'll remember that.
What are you going to be when you grow up?
I want to take up aviation.
I want to go to college and be a cardiovascular surgeon.
I want to be all right.
He want to be the first baseball player and lawyer in space.
I just really want to go home.
That'd be one of the greatest gifts you would ever receive.
Oh my God, this is me so happy to be home.
Oh, it's gonna feel like heaven.
That would be the happiest child on earth.
How happy they'll be? They'll be glad. Hysterical. Wow.
A little help is always needed, you know, and appreciated.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Brad Pitt.
I just needed a reason to touch him.
Here we go.
All right, you good? Okay. Okay. Now, tonight isn't just about raising money. Sometimes to help people, we have to travel outside our comfort zone to really understand another situation. With that in mind, the biggest selling band of last year took themselves off to Uganda a couple of weeks ago and made this tape for us. Ladies and gentlemen, Daughtry.
Child is feeling empty heart. His love is fading. All the things that we are not seeing. Can we see beyond the scars to make through the night? Love, we'll find you. What about now? What about today? What if you're making me all that I was meant to be? What if I love and never went away? What if it's lost behind words we could never find? Maybe before it's too late, what about now? The The sun is breaking in your eyes to start a new day. This broken heart can still survive with a touch of your grace. Shadows fade into the light. Well, I am by your side. Well, love, we'll find you. What about now? What about today? What if you make me all that I was meant to be? What if our love never went away? What if it's lost behind words we could never find? Baby, before it's too late. Baby, what about now?
What about now?
What about today?
Before it's too late.
Hey folks, we're Daughtry, and thanks for tuning in tonight. We're here in Uganda, and what we've seen over the past couple days is just too hard to describe. We've met some amazing people with an unbelievable will to live, and they need your help. They need whatever you can give. Pick up the phone right now and dial 1-877-IDLE-AID. That's 1-877-436-5243. Call now. They need you.
Now, it's a great pleasure to introduce our next act tonight. Not only because she's a superstar, but also because we finally get to see if Randy Jackson is any good on the bass. Singing Fly Like a Bird, Mariah Carey.
Weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning.
Somehow I know that there's a place up above. No more hurt and suffering. Free of all the trust of chains and suffering. Because I feel the unconditional love. The one who cares enough for me.
Oh,
keep donating. Please call and donate now. God bless you. Thank you so much. Randy Jackson on the bass, ladies and gentlemen.
That's all we have time for tonight. It's been an unforgettable evening. The lines will stay open, and you can also donate online at AmericanIdol.com. Thanks to all of our stars, thanks to our sponsors, and thanks to everyone who has given already. The people you've helped will never meet you, but let us thank you on their behalf. We're back in business tomorrow night, live with your results. Once again, remember, all the music you've seen can be downloaded exclusively on iTunes, and the proceeds will go to charity. Now, singing Shout to the Lord, once again, your American Idols. Good night, everybody.
My shepherd, my Savior, Lord, there is none like you.
How's it going? How we doing? We reach a gugillion yet? Huh? Idol gets back. Where's everybody? Come on. What's going on? Where's everybody? Where's Seacrest? Huh? Kodak? What the f***? Seacrest? Seacrest? Every time. Ooh, come. Be on Idol gives back. Not funny, Ryan.